this Renaissance Impressions concert, and it's my pleasure to be able to be here playing with my colleague Joao with some good duet with for everybody. And what we just played is a piece called Queen's Treble, and which is basically Joao is playing a lot of diminutions, fast notes on the lute, and I'm playing a ground, so we call this like treble ground lute duet. And the ground is kind of like the same chord progression, keep going and going and repeating. And upcoming we have a couple more lute duets and then lute solos, so we hope that you will enjoy the entire program. Next we will be playing by the same composer, John Johnson, called the Nuts Be Brown, which is another diminution and ground duet. The flat Papon and flat Gallia, also by John Johnson. On the lute itself, and tuning is a huge issue. So what we spend most of the time people joke about compared to playing the guitar is tuning the instrument, and unfortunately sometimes the humidity and the weather is not allowing the instrument to stay in tune. So Well, while Joao is tuning, I'm gonna introduce the lute a little bit. If you see the poster out there, actually, you are not seeing the Renaissance lute itself. What is on the poster is the mandolin. And obviously, it's a mistake to put that on the poster. And the Renaissance lute is tracing back to the 15th century, and you can find a lot of music in Europe and in specifically in England, and there's lots of great pieces written by composers over there. Next in the program, we will be playing, taking turns to play some solos for everybody. And you will see the British composer, his name John Dowland, appearing a lot in the program. And this is no mistake, but John Dowland is pretty prolific and well known in the lute repertoire. And He wrote a lot of different styles, and not only just for the lute, but also for vocal and lute. Unfortunately, today we cannot fit another type of very popular Elizabethan period genre of lute song in the program, but we try to give you a little bit of taste how this instrument back in the 15th century, in the Renaissance period, lutenists will be give you an idea. They might be playing the lute next to the queen or like important people next to their bed so that they can, I don't know, provide music for them for entertainment or play music for them to go to sleep, something like that. So obviously this instrument is very, very quiet and it's not intended for playing over 100 people. So today we're using the amplification so that you can get to listen to the music more clear. And perhaps the lute should be around the quietest, the most quiet instrument in the amount all. If you think about guitar, it's already very quiet, the lute is even more quiet. So without further introduction, I'm going to play you some pieces by John Dowland, which is the Frog Galliard and then also the Fantasia in G minor. So these two pieces are very lively in a way, and we try to provide you a different type of perspective of the lute music so that you can get a glimpse of everything. So here is Frog Galliard. Thank you. next, I'll be playing some Celtic, Scottish music for you, and this is a huge contrast compared to what you just heard from the Elizabethan court music by John Dowland. And these are very fun pieces to play, and it looks like there's like a lot of pieces, and it might take a lot of time. Actually, lute music is rather short, and you most oftentimes you will be able to find music like 1 minute, less than a minute, and something super, super short. Compared to guitar music, if you think about how plucked instruments music was developed, probably people back in time, they wrote very short music and then getting longer and longer and longer, something like that. So does that mean lute doesn't have long music? Actually, yes, there are some music lasting for 6 minutes, even longer, and or even like a set of pieces. So I'm going to play all these five Scottish music from the same lute book for you, and hope you enjoy them. Thank you. To finish my solo set, I'll be playing two more pieces by John Dowland. One is Lacrimate, and then finishing with a very interesting tremolo fantasy.